वेलकम बैक टू अवर चैनल रेस्पेक्ट एजुकेशन। नाउ वी सी क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 एंड 9th वन, थर्ड वन एंड 9th वन। सो इफ यू कंपेयर ऑल द ऑप्शंस, ऑप्शन सी इज द राइट आंसर। Not a decomposition reaction. Sulfide crystals, before heating, they have the color that is green. Now we see chemistry chapter 1, chemical reactions and equations, in which worksheet 2. First round multiple choice questions. In that question number 1, Sunita takes about 2 grams of ferrous sulfide crystals. Ferrous sulfide crystals in a dry boiling tube and heat the boiling tube over the flame of a burner or spirit lamp as shown in the figure. See, here is the girl. She has taken ferrous sulfate crystals in this test tube, that is of about 2 grams. Now here she made it heat, okay, by using a burner, Bunsen burner or a spirit lamp. So here it says that, see, this is the boiling tube. And here it is, ferrous sulfate crystals are there inside the tube. And here is the burner. And here, wafting gas gently towards the nose means here she is getting little bit, a kind of, okay, suffocation like that. So she is moving away the, she is moving the gas evolved into the air. Now, here do not point the mouth of boiling tube at your neighbors or yourself. Means actually here the gas, whatever it comes, it will give little bit suffocation. That's why here it is said that you have to keep little bit far away from our face, mouth or nose. Okay. Now the question is that the color of the crystals after heating. Actually here ferrous sulfide crystals before heating they have the color that is green. And after heating they turn into brown. So here option B is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 2. Which of the following are combination reactions? Combination reaction means two or more elements combine together to form a single compound. So here reactants should be more, whereas the product should be only single, only one. Let us see here. See, single reactant, it can't be combination. See, two reactants and a single product, it is a combination reaction. See, two reactants, single product, it's a combination reaction. Two reactants and two products, so it can't be combination. So here from the options, you see second one and third one. Option D, second one and third one. Option D is the right answer. Now we see question number 3. The given diagram represents a dash reaction. Here you see there is a test tube in which mercury oxide is taken and here it is heated using a Bunsen burner or a spirit lamp. Now here which kind of reaction it is? See, any chemical reaction, it is caused by giving heat, that is called thermal decomposition. So here for the third question, option A is the right answer. Now we see question number 4. Which among the following is or are double displacement reaction? Actually, double displacement reaction means the reaction occur when parts of two ionic compounds are exchanged or making two new compounds. See, here these two, if you observe, Pb plus CuCl2. So here copper is displaced by the Pb, means lead. So this is just displacement, whereas if you observe here, Na2SO4 plus BaCl2, Ba has come towards the SO4, Na2 has gone towards Cl. So this is what exchanging by making new compounds. So this is double displacement. So option 2 is double displacement. And here C plus O2 gives us to CO2, two or more combined together to single form. So this is single compound. So this is combination. Here you see CH4 plus 2O2 becomes CO2 plus 2H2O. So here this is also no exchanging is done. So only thing is here in option 2, here Ba comes to the first place, Na goes to the second place. So here only second one. So from the options you see B, second one only, that is option B. Option B is the right answer. Now we see next question, that is question number 5. You are given the following chemical equation. Mg plus CuO gives rise to MgO plus Cu. This equation represents. Here, see, for Mg, oxygen is added. Adding oxygen is called oxidation. Adding oxygen is called oxidation. So here we can say that MgO gets oxidized. At the same time, see, CuO becomes copper. So here removal of the oxygen. Earlier, addition of the oxygen. Now here it is removal of the oxygen. Copper oxide becomes copper. So removal of oxygen is called reduction. Removal of oxygen is called reduction. So here in a single chemical reaction, both have taken place. Reduction as well as oxidation. See, starting three letters, red, and here OX, ox. So if you write together, that is called redox. So here this is redox reaction. Whereas here both oxidation means addition of oxygen and reduction, that is removal of oxygen, both have taken place simultaneously in the same equation or same reaction. So it is called redox reaction. Other than that, here see, from copper oxide, copper is displaced by magnesium. See, earlier it was copper oxide. Now at the end we got magnesium oxide. That means here copper is displaced by magnesium, since magnesium is the higher reactive or more reactive than copper. So here this is a displacement reaction also. So this is redox, at the same time displacement also. So let us see the options. That is, here is option C, redox reaction as well as displacement reaction. So here option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 6. Rahul poured clear solution of test tube A and equal quantity of solution of test tube B in a conical flask. See here, this is a solution from test tube A and this is solution from test tube B. Shaked it well and kept undisturbed for some time. After some time, white precipitate settled down below a clear solution in the flask. See here, this is the white precipitate. Its name is given as BgSO4, that is solid. And here the above this one, clear solution, that is NaCl, that is aqueous. Rahul forgot to write the name of the solution in the test tube A. What it can be? Let us see here. If you observe carefully, the products are NaCl is one of the product and BgSO4 is the another product. So here I am writing NaCl and BaSO4, these are the products, right? And here if you observe, one of the reactants is given. See, if you observe carefully in the test tube B, the name is given. For your convenience, I am zooming it. See here, observe carefully, it is BaCl2. So here I am writing, it is BaCl2, barium chloride. Okay, let us come back. Okay, so it is one of the reactants is BaCl2. Now here I am writing BaCl2, barium chloride. Now the question is that we are asked to find the another reactant that is there in test tube A. See, here BA, Cl2, Cl, so NaSO4 is left. So here NaSO4 means sodium sulfate. It is a double displacement, they exchange. Okay, here the atoms get exchanged. So here NaSO4 plus BaCl2 becomes, Ba comes here, BaSO4, and Na should go there, that is NaCl. So here, as he forgot to write the name of the solution in test tube A, test tube A will be having definitely NaSO4 because test tube B has BaCl2, so that these are the products. Okay, so here option you see, sodium sulfate, NaSO4, option D is the right answer. Now we see question number 7. Iron powder and powder of rust are taken in two containers X and Y respectively. Dilute sulfuric acid is added to both the containers. See, iron powder, iron is a metal. Iron powder is a metal. So here metal, and here powder of rust is non-metal. This is non-metal. So for both here acid H2SO4 is dilute H2SO4 is added. So here H2SO4 is added. Now here, then what happens? Let us see here, metal plus acid gives us, here it gives us a kind of liquid with bubbles, liquid with bubbles. Whereas non-metal plus H2SO4, it won't give liquid with bubbles. Liquid with bubbles is called effervescence. So here we can see the effervescence in the test tube X because X has metal plus H2SO4. Whereas effervescence can't be seen in Y because it has non-metal plus, means metal oxide it is. Okay, rust is called metal oxide. Metal oxide plus H2SO4, it won't give liquid with bubbles. So here let us see the options. From the options we can see effervescence is observed in case of X but not in Y. So option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 8. Based on the reaction given below, what is the correct decreasing order of reactivity of metals? Let us see here each reaction carefully. Zn plus CuSO4 becomes ZnSO4 plus Cu. That means here you see copper is displaced by zinc. So zinc has come to the copper place. Copper is sent out. So here zinc is here more reactive than copper. Right? Now let us see second one. Fe when it is added to CuSO4, here FeSO4 plus here copper should come. It is given wrong little bit here. It is copper. So that means here you see from copper sulfate solution, copper is displaced by Fe. That means here who displaced? Fe displaced. Whom it displaced? Copper. So copper is displaced by Fe. So Fe is the more reactive than copper. Now let us see here. Same logic. See, from AgNO3, Ag is sent out by copper. So here copper is powerful, means more reactive than Ag, means silver. Copper is more reactive than silver. Here you see, zinc plus FeSO4, Fe is sent out. So here zinc, Fe is sent out by zinc. So we consider Fe is displaced by zinc. So zinc is the more reactive than iron. Now here, let us compare all the four. So on comparing one and the first one, second one, third one, everything, if you compare carefully, here this is what zinc is already greater than Fe. Zinc is already greater than Fe. Fe is already greater than copper, right? Copper is already greater than Ag. Is it clear? Now here this is the decreasing order of the reactivity metals. So here this is the more reactive, and then that see among these, this is the most reactive among only these. So this is the decreasing order. Now let us see the options. Option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 9. Sort out the following reactions into group A, that is precipitation reactions, group B, that is redox reactions, and group C, that is neutralization reactions. So here there are certain reactions are given, like 9 reactions are given. We are going to arrange them like group A, means all the precipitation reactions come under group A, and all the redox reactions should be written under group B, and neutralization reactions can be written under group C. Let us check one by one. H2S hydrogen sulfide plus SO2 gives rise to S plus H2O. So here when hydrogen sulfide reacts with sulfur dioxide, we get sulfur and water. See here, sulfur can be left over as a precipitation. So here, this first one is a precipitation reaction. So it comes under group A, right? At the same time, if you observe carefully, here this oxygen is removed from SO2, so it becomes S. So here it gets removal of oxygen is nothing but reduction. So here at the same time, for hydrogen oxygen is added, so addition of hydrogen, addition of oxygen is called oxidation. So here reduction and oxidation both together take place. That's why here this is redox reaction also. So first one comes under A and B group. Let us see second one is NaCl plus AgNO3 gives rise to AgCl plus NaNO3. This is also a precipitation reaction. Here when we add NaCl to AgNO3, we get here AgCl and NaNO3. So this is sodium chloride, and here silver nitrate give us silver chloride and sodium nitrate. So here this comes under precipitation reaction, that will be like group A. Now let us see here third one, that is 2 times NaOH plus H2SO4 give us Na2SO4 plus H2O. See, OH group, this is base, H2SO4 is acid. Base plus acid give us salt and water. This is called neutralization reaction. Neutralization reaction is under group C. So this equation comes under group C. Now let us see fourth one. That is here NH4NO3 on heating it becomes N2O and 2H2O. So here this is a decomposition reaction. Single reactant can be splitted into two or more products. We know that all decomposition reactions are redox reactions. So here fourth one can be redox reaction. So it comes under B, group B. Now we see fifth one. That is AgBr gives rise to Ag plus Br2. See, this is silver bromide. When it is exposed to air under sunlight, here it is sunlight. So it turns into Ag and Br2. Bromine gas will be entered the air, so it can be passed off. At the same time, Ag can be left over as precipitation. So here this is precipitation reaction. At the same time, here this is decomposition reaction also. So single reactant can be splitted as more products. So it is decomposition. Decomposition can also be called as, means also all decomposition reactions are redox reactions. So this fifth one also, it can be redox reaction. Now let us see sixth one. That is here Zn plus CuSO4 gives rise to ZnSO4 plus Cu. Here this is zinc sulfate and copper. So copper can be left as here precipitation. When we add zinc to copper sulfate, add zinc is more reactive than the copper, so it displaces. So copper can be displaced and zinc occupies the place of copper. So that becomes zinc sulfate and copper. So here copper is left as precipitation. So this is precipitation reaction. At the same time, here if you observe it carefully, CuSO4 becomes a Cu, that means oxygen is removed. When oxygen is removed, that is reduction. For zinc, here see, oxygen is added, so it is oxidation. So both together it is a redox reaction also. So sixth one become both precipitation as well as redox. Now let us see seventh one. Seventh one is CH3CH2OH gives rise to CH3CHO plus H2. So Here, this is single reactant becomes two or more products. It is a decomposition reaction. All decomposition reactions are redox reactions. So it comes under group B. Now let us see the eighth one. That is BaCl2 plus H2SO4 gives rise to BaSO4 plus 2HCl. So here barium chloride and sulfuric acid, when they react each other, we get barium sulfate and hydrochloric acid. Barium sulfate can be left as precipitate, that is insoluble. So it is a precipitate. It comes under precipitating reaction. So here it comes under group A. Now let us see last one, that is ninth one. HNO3 plus CaOH twice gives rise to CaNO3 twice plus H2O. HNO3 is acetic acid, it is acid. At the same time, here CaOH twice is base. So acid plus base. So both give us salt and water. So here it is, this one comes under group C. See, this is nitric acid and here calcium hydroxide. This is acid, this is base. Both together give us salt and water. So it comes under neutralization reaction. So it comes under C. Now let us check here, you see. Group A, 1, 2, 5, 6, 8. See, group A, 1, 2, 5, 6, 8. Group B, 1, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Group B, 1, 4, 5, 6 and then 7. Group C, third one and ninth one. Third one and ninth one. So if we compare all the options, option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 10. Identify the type of reaction for each of the following, as here certain definitions are given: combination, E denoted by P, decomposition denoted by Q, displacement by R, double displacement by S, combustion by T. Now let us see here, there are 4 points are given, let us see one by one. A compound breaks apart into elements. See here, a compound breaks apart into its elements. That means single compound is broken into two or more simple substances. This is nothing but the definition of decomposition. So here this is suitable for Q, because Q is for decomposition. Now let us see second one. A metal and a non-metal react to form an ionic compound. Here you see two or more compounds react to form a single compound. This is nothing but combination. Combination is P, right? And next one is, let us see third one. A compound of hydrogen and carbon reacts with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water. Reacts with oxygen is nothing but combustion. So that is T. This is T. Let us see last one. Silver ion from AgNO3, that is aqueous, forms a precipitate with bromide ion, that is from KBr aqueous. Let us write the suitable equation for this fourth one. Here I am writing, that is, here AgNO3 reacts with KBr to get KNO3 plus AgBr, right? So here AgBr, it is the insoluble, that is also called insoluble precipitation. This is precipitation. So it will be seen shown like this. So precipitation. Now here silver ion, that is AgNO3, reacts with KBr and we get one precipitation, that is AgBr in fact. So this is what you see, they exchange their ions. See, Ag with Br and K with NO3. This is double displacement. Here double displacement nothing but S. So this last one is S. Now let us see the options. First one Q, 1Q, 2R, sorry 2P, 3T, 4S. 1Q, 2P, 3T. 3T. So here 4S. Option B is the right answer for this question. Now let us see question number 11. When ferrous sulfate is heated strongly, it undergoes decomposition to form ferric oxide as main product, accompanied by a change in color from, here the question is from which color to which color. This kind of question is seen in the beginning of the same worksheet. There I have told you its initial color. Here this one, ferrous sulfate initial color is green. After heating it will become like ferric oxide and its color is of brown. So here it is from green to brown. So let us see the options. Here green to brown. So option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 12. Rohit and Mayuri conducted two experiments to study the types of chemical reactions as shown in the given figures. See, this is the experiment done by both Rohit and Mayuri, experiment 1 and experiment 2. First, here they have taken the lead nitride crystals and they heated using burner. Okay, now let us see here what happens. When lead nitrate is burnt, here NO2 nitrogen dioxide and O2, two gases will be released. They will be evolved. That is what your vapors of X means, NO2 and O2. Right? Here, if we see the color of NO2, color of NO2, NO2 has actually here like reddish brown color. This is reddish brown. Which one? NO2. Whereas O2 colorless. This is colorless gas. Right. And here the leftover residue after completion of the experiment, here in this lead oxide can be left. See, here I am writing, this is lead oxide, PbO. In short, I am writing lead oxide, whose color is yellow color. It can be left over, left like precipitate. Now here let us see the experiment 1 details first. In experiment 1, yellow residue is left behind. See here, yellow residue, lead oxide. While in experiment 2, that will be okay checked afterwards. So in experiment 1, this is true. First point is true in experiment 1. This is true. In both experiments, two different gases were given out. Here two different gases were given out in the experiment 1 at present. Experiment 1 is true. The colorless gas evolved, that is O2, in experiment 1 extinguishes the glowing splint, while the gas evolved in experiment 2. Experiment 2 will be checked later. In experiment 1, O2, actually O2, it doesn't extinguish. Extinguishing means it puts off. But oxygen is a supporter of combustion. Okay, because of that the glowing splint will be more, but it won't be extinguished. So this point is false according to the experiment 1. Now X means here the vapors of NO2 is reddish brown. Yes, it is reddish brown. So here according to the experiment 1, only third point is false. Now let us check experiment 2. Here experiment 2 is done by taking ferrous sulfate crystals. When we heat ferrous sulfate crystals, first the crystals, they lose water, then they can be converted as anhydrous FeSO4. Anhydrous FeSO4 means FeSO4 without water molecules. For example, if we heat further more, at this stage when the water crystals are lost, then it changes its color from, earlier it was in light green. Which one? Ferrous sulfate is light green. It turns to white because it lost water molecules. Okay, it turns to white. Now if you on further heating of this FeSO4, then it FeSO4 decomposes into ferric oxide. Its formula is Fe2O3. Fe2O3 ferric oxide, Fe2O3, whose color is reddish brown. Its color is reddish brown. And here, while the experiment is moving on, two gases will be evolved. One of them is sulfur dioxide SO2 and other one is sulfur trioxide SO3. These gases are evolved. Now, let us check out here the remaining part. While in experiment 2, reddish brown solid, that is ferric oxide Fe2O3, is left behind. So this point is also true. So ultimately first point is true, completely first point is true for the both experiments. Now here, let us check about the second point. In both experiments, two different gases were given out. See here, SO2, SO3, two different gases. So this is also true. Ultimately, second point completely true. Third one. Here, while the gas ever in experiment 2 turns green solution of acidified KMnO4 orange. Actually here, KMnO4 means it is potassium permanganate, or it can be called as potassium manganate 7. But actually, this SO2 or SO3, SO2, it won't turn KMnO4 orange to green. It will turn K2Cr2O7, which was in orange, that will be turned to green, not KMnO4. It turns K2Cr2O7, potassium dichromate solution. Acidified potassium dichromate, which was there in the orange color, on passing sulfur dioxide gas, it can be turned to green, but not KMnO4. Here KMnO4 is given. That's why here in experiment 2 also, the given statement is false. So here this is incorrect, false I am writing. Let us see fourth one. X is reddish, already it is tested in experiment 1, whereas Y and Z, these two, sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, both have burning of sulfur smell, definitely, because here sulfur is one of the constituents in both. Therefore, here option 4 also true for both. Now the question is that, the incorrect observation is, the incorrect observation is only one, that is option 3 only. So for this question, option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 13. Rahul, a class 10 student, conducted two experiments as follows. So he did the experiment 1 as, excess calcium carbonate was added to 100 cm cube of 0.2 mole per dm cube HCl at 25 degrees Celsius or centigrade. Experiment 2, he did as, excess calcium carbonate was added to 80 cm cube. See here, 100 becomes 80 cm cube of same HCl of concentration x moles per dm cube. See here, earlier it was 0.2, now here it became x, and at a temperature of y degree Celsius. Earlier it was 25 degree Celsius, now it is y degree Celsius. Now here it is given, the graph is given. See, experiment 1, it moves in this way, that is a volume of CO2 in cm cube. So it increased. Experiment 2, the graph has gone in this way. Now following curves show the results of the experiments. Now the question is that, identify x and y. X means how many moles per dm cube, that is to be found, and y, the temperature also to be found. Here this is a simple mathematical calculation, because here you see HCl is not at all changed. So same calcium carbonate is not at all changed. Everything is same, excess calcium carbonate, here also excess calcium carbonate. So here simple, let us here write for 100 cm cube, it is 0.2. See here I am doing, for 100 cm cube, I am writing here cm cube, it is 0.2 moles per dm cube. Now the question is that, for 80 cm cube, see I am writing under 100, I am writing 80, how many mole per dm cube, I am taking it as x. So it is just like unitary method. Let us do cross multiplication. Here it becomes, here it will be 100 into x equal to 80 into 0.2. when you multiply 80 into 0.2, it is 8 into 10 into 0.2. 10 into 0.2 is 2, so 8 2s are 16. So from this we can write that x equal to 16 by 100, that is 0.16. Now here, let us find y, the value of y also. Now we see y, here also same logic, here I am writing cm cube and here is degree Celsius. So for 100 cm cube, it is given as 25 degree Celsius. Now the question is that for 80 cm cube, here how much temperature? I am taking it as y because it is given as y. Let us do again same cross multiplication. This will be 100 into y. 100 into y equal to 80 into 25. Now here y is equal to, this is into, it is not x, okay, it is into. So 80 into 25 divided by 100. Now here we can cancel it. This is 25 1 jar, 25 4 jar, 4 1 jar, 4 20 jar. So finally here y is 20 degree Celsius. Now we get x is 0.16 mole per dm cube and y is 20 degree Celsius. So let us see the options here. Here you see 0.15, 0.16. So when we draw the graph, as per our convenient, we are taking it as 0.15. See 0.15, 0.20, 0.25, 0.30, 0.435, 0.40. So here he is taking 0.05 as the gap difference. So here, of course, these two indicate the same. So 0.16, while drawing the graph, it can be taken as 0.15 according to our convenience. So here x is 0.15 and y is 20, therefore option A is the right answer for this question 13th one. Now we see question number 14. Which of the following is not a decomposition reaction? Actually, decomposition reaction means a single compound can be broken into more substances, more simpler substances. So here you see single means here reactant should be single and a product should be more. So single reactant, more products, single reactant, more products, single reactant, more products. But here you see more reactant, single product. This is combination reaction. So this is not a decomposition. So here option C is the right answer. Now let us see question number 15. That is, digestion of food in our body is an example of which kind of reaction? Actually, digestion of food is a chemical change because the large macromolecules are broken down into simpler molecules by the enzymes present in our stomach. That means here, one bigger compound can be broken into simpler substances. Means here, one reactant can be broken into more products. So this is also nothing but decomposition reaction. So here, from the options you see, option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 16. In a decomposition reaction, as we know, decomposition reaction, it has only one reactant and more products. The reactants are generally two ionic compounds in aqueous. Actually, decomposition reaction, it doesn't have the more reactants, means two reactants is not possible. So this is false. And here the reactants are usually a metal and a non-metal. Again, there are two, but decomposition has only one reactant. So this is also false. And here the energy is in the form of heat and light is absorbed. It might be true. Why? Because here to get a decomposition, sometimes the compound is to be either heated, or either heat energy or light energy is required. See, certain compounds under the sunlight, they decomposes. Certain compounds on heating, they decompose. So here either heat and light absorption is very, very important. So this is the right option. One of the reactions is often water. Okay, it may or may not be, it is not compulsory. So here option C is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 17. One day Mohan was performing an experiment in the laboratory. By mistake, he leaves the iron nail in the copper sulfate solution for 1 week. After 1 week, the color of the sulfate solution is, see, when iron is left in copper sulfate solution, then iron gets brown color. Iron nail get brown color. Whereas copper sulfate solution, initial color, it was blue, it turns to finally green. Now here, according to the question, it is asked that after 1 week, what is the color of the copper sulfate solution? Actually here, after 1 week, the solution turns from blue to green. So finally it will be having green in color. So here option A is the right answer for this question. Now we see question number 18. The displacement reaction between iron 3 oxide and metal X is used for welding the rail tracks. Here X is copper granules, magnesium ribbon, sodium pellets or aluminium powder. Here the reduction of any metal oxide, especially iron metal oxide, to form metal by using here especially a powder, that is aluminium powder, is to be used because here aluminium powder acts as a reducing agent and this reaction is also called thermite reaction. Okay, why do we use only aluminium powder in this kind of reaction where large amount of heat is evolved? So with which we can join the broken pieces of like rail tracks and all. So here aluminium powder, option D is the right answer. Now we see next question, that is question number 19. A small amount of copper powder is heated as shown in the figure. Which reaction shows the above process? So here a copper powder is taken and then here it is okay heated with using a burner. Now here the question is, it's a combustion reaction. So copper reacts with oxygen, will copper oxide. So here copper reacts with oxygen, will get copper oxide. Here if you observe, option 3 also gives the same. But when you compare these two, this is the balanced one. See, two copper, two copper, two oxygen, two oxygen. So here only one copper, two copper. It is unbalanced equation. So from the options, option A is the right answer. Now we see question number 20. What kind of reaction is it? 4Fe plus 3O2 gives us to 2Fe2O3. So here you see two or more compounds combine together to form a single compound. It's a combination reaction. But here you see in the options, nowhere combination is given. So here it is not decomposition, not single displacement, not double displacement. So it should be synthesis. Let us check how far it is true. See here, we have certain types of chemical reactions in which, see, if A plus B together AB, this is combination reaction. Combination reaction can also be said as synthesis. So from this we can write option A is the right answer for the question 20th one. Now we see Roman number 2. These are comprehension type questions in which comprehension 1 is given as change in state, change in color, evolution of a gas, change in temperature and formation of precipitate. These observations help us to determine whether a chemical reaction has taken place or not. Chemical changes are caused by chemical reactions. Now there are some questions. Let us see question number 21. Solution of Al2SO4 thrice, FeSO4, CuSO4 and ZnSO4 were separately taken in 4 test tubes and some iron fillings were added in each of these test tubes. After few minutes, a student would observe that the color of which solution or which solutions changed. That is the question. So before entering the question, we should know the reactivity series. Let us see the series. Here I am writing potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium. These are highly reactive metals. And continuation, carbon, and then here zinc, iron, tin, lead, and then hydrogen, copper, silver, gold, and then platinum. So this is what descending order of reactivity of the metals means. Among these, this is the most reactive metal and this is the least reactive metal, and of course these are the lower reactive metals and these are the medium. So these are the medium and these are the highest or the most reactive metals. Now let us here compare. See, aluminium, it is here, right? Iron, it is after aluminium. Copper, it is almost on the third, and means third, okay, grade. And here zinc is here in the second grade. Now if you observe carefully, here copper is the least reactive metal. So after few minutes, a student would observe that the color of which color would be changed. Here definitely iron, you compare iron with aluminium. Since aluminium is the higher reactive than iron, iron won't change it. So it will be as it is. Here FeSO4, moreover you are adding iron. In iron sulfate you are adding iron. So here it won't give that much effect. At the same time ZnSO4, you see, if you add iron fillings in ZnSO4, there will be no reaction, because here this is a less reactive than zinc, or in fact zinc is the more reactive than iron. But when you compare iron with CuSO4, iron and copper, then definitely this copper will be displaced by iron, because iron is the more reactive than copper. So in this list, iron can displace only copper. So from the options, you see CuSO4 solution only changed after a few minutes. CuSO4 solution only changed. In other options, you see zinc is there, aluminium is there, zinc is there, aluminium is there, Fe is there. So here all solutions can't be changed. So option A, only CuSO4, that too the reason is that iron is the more reactive than copper. So here option A is the right answer. Now we see question number 22. When magnesium ribbon is heated in a Bunsen flame, it burns with a bright flame and white powder is formed because burning of magnesium in air is a chemical change. Here the observation is that when the magnesium ribbon is heated using a Bunsen burner, then here it is observed that it burns with a bright flame and white powder is formed. This is what observation. So observation is true. That is what happened when magnesium ribbon is burned. Now, because the reason is that burning of magnesium in air is a chemical change. This is also correct. So here let us see the options. Observation is correct, reason is wrong. No, reason is also correct. Here is observation is wrong, reason is correct. Observation is also correct, it is given wrong. Observation is correct and reason is correct. So both are correct. This is the right option. So option C is the right answer for the question 22nd one. Now we see question number 23. Observe the given experimental setup carefully. See, in the first beaker, sodium sulfite is taken, in that dilute H2SO4 is added. Now some gas is evolved. Through the delivery tube, it enters the second test tube, which contains orange solution of acidified K2Cr2O7. When the gas evolved, it enters here, then this orange color turns to green. Okay, orange will be turned to green. Now this is what will be happened in experiment 1. Let us see experiment number 2. When there are some zinc granules are taken, in that dilute H2SO4 is added. It is exothermic reaction. This is exothermic reaction, means heat will be given out, heat is given out. And third one, you see, when barium hydroxide, means BaOH twice, added to ammonium chloride NH4Cl, then what happens here, this is called endothermic reaction. This is endothermic reaction. That means it requires heat to further, okay, to do the further experiment. Now here let us see the observations. Which of the given observations is incorrect, means which is wrong? In experiment 1, orange solution of acidified potassium dichromate, that is K2Cr2O7 is potassium dichromate, turns green, turns green. This is true. And in experiment 2, the beaker becomes warm. Means beaker becomes hot. Yes, it is because it is exothermic, it becomes hot. So this is also true. In experiment 3, test tube becomes cold since it is endothermic. Okay, it requires heat. The outside will be cool. So this is also true. Now here, which is wrong? Because none of these is wrong. This means all are correct. So option D is the right answer. Now we see question number 24. Zinc pieces were placed in each of the four test tubes containing different salt solutions as shown below. See here, here the salt solution is sodium sulfate solution in which zinc pieces are kept. Same here, zinc sulfate solution where zinc pieces are kept inside. Iron sulfate solution in that again zinc pieces are there. Copper sulfate solution in that again zinc pieces are there. In which cases will color change be observed in solutions? See, this question depends on the activity series. This is the here reaction between sodium with zinc, zinc with zinc, iron with zinc, copper with zinc. If you compare sodium and zinc, sodium is higher reactive than zinc. So here, zinc cannot displace sodium from its sulfate solution. So this is not possible. Zinc and zinc both are same. So this is also not possible. Only thing is, what will happen with zinc and iron and zinc and copper? Let us see here. Once again, we'll see the reactivity series, what I explained earlier. See, zinc with sodium, no reaction. Because sodium is the higher reactive metal here. Now, zinc and iron, so that zinc can replace, and zinc and copper, again zinc can replace. So here zinc can replace Fe from its salt solution and also copper from its salt solution. So here let us come back. Here zinc can replace iron from its sulfate solution, zinc can replace copper from its sulfate solution. So option 3 and 4, in these two, the color of the salt solution can be changed. So option 3 and 4 means option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 25. The below three beakers are observed by Anjali after 4 hours of addition of metal sulfate and metals. The indication after the reaction, based on that, choose the correct statements. See, this is what? These are the three different kinds of experiments which are already have been completed. Now here you see, the solution is XSO4, whereas the leftover residue is W. That means here clearly we can say X is more reactive than W. That's why W has left here as residue. Clear? So here we can write it as, from 1 we can say X is greater than W. X is more reactive than W. Second one, you see, W is there in the solution whereas Z is left over here. So W is more reactive than Z. W is more reactive than Z. Clear? Here you see, Z is there in the solution whereas Y is left over here. So Z is more reactive than Y. Now here, let us read single conclusion here, that X is more reactive than W, whereas W is more reactive than Z, whereas Z is more reactive than Y. Let us see the options now here. First one, W is more reactive than X. W, is it more reactive than X? No, this is false. Here it asks, choose the correct statements. So now here, W is less reactive than Z. Is it less? No, it is more. So this is also false. X is more reactive than Z. Obviously, see, X is more reactive than Z. Clearly it is. So this is true. Y is more reactive than W. No, W is more reactive than Y. So this is false. From the options, you see, option C is only the correct statement. Now we see question number 26. A student added a metal in native form to another metal salt solution, and after some time he found that the color of the metal salt solution fades away and a reddish brown deposit is observed. Imagine that the reaction as M plus NX gives rise to MX plus N. So here you observe, this is the salt solution. M displaces N, or we can say N is displaced by M, both are same. Now here M is the most reactive metal, or we can say M is the more reactive than N. That is the reason N is displaced by M. So M has occupied the place of N. Then choose the correct possibilities of M, means more reactive one, and N less reactive one, and then annex the salt solution respectively. Let us see first option, aluminium, copper, copper sulfate. Here you see the reactivity series, aluminium and then copper. On comparing these two, this is the more reactive, this is the less reactive. So here aluminium is more, this is more reactive, this is less reactive, means N, therefore it is less reactive salt, NX. Okay, now here let us see B bit. Here you see Zn and Cu. See Zn zinc and copper. Here also Zn is more reactive than copper. So here Zn is given as capital M and copper will be N. Therefore here this will be N and X, it's salt. Okay, NX. Same way, now let us compare sodium with copper. See here sodium and then copper. Here also sodium is more reactive than copper. So here sodium is more reactive and copper will be N. This will be NX. So in all the cases you see, here in all the cases M N NX. So all the possibilities are correct possibilities. So option D is the right answer. Now we see question number 27. X plus CuCl2 gives rise to XCl2 plus copper. Here you see, from here copper chloride, copper is displaced by X. See, X has come and occupied the place of copper. Copper is sent out. That means here X is more reactive than copper. In that case only, this metal can replace or displace the copper. Right? In the above reaction, the metal X can be off. Let us see the reactivity series. Here you see given options Az, Au, Pb and Hg. Let us see the reactivity series here. See, Az, it is lesser reactive than copper, so it cannot displace it. So Az can't be the option. Next one is given here, it has Au. Au also lesser reactive than copper. See, these are there after the position of copper, so they cannot displace copper at all. So Au can't be the option. And Hg, mercury, that is also after copper it is there, so it cannot displace copper. And only one is that is what here, Pb, lead. Lead is there, you see, it is there before copper. That means Pb, means lead, is more reactive than copper. So lead only can displace copper from its salt solution, that is from copper chloride. So here X should be only Pb. So option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 28. A reddish brown colored metal used in electric wires, when powdered and heated strongly in an open china dish, its color turns black. When hydrogen gas is passed over this black substance, it regains its original color. Based on this information, the metal and black colored substances are dash. In fact, see, in electric wires mostly we use, okay, either copper or silver. Mostly we use copper. And when copper is heated strongly in an open china dish, then only it turns black. The black substance is called copper oxide. When hydrogen gas is passed over the copper oxide, again you will get the original color, means you will get copper back. So here, according to the given data, option C, copper, the metal is copper, and its oxide is copper oxide. See, it turns black. So copper oxide, copper and copper oxide, that is option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 29, that is comprehension 3. Marble's popularity began in ancient Rome and Greece, where white and half white marble were used to construct a variety of structures, from handheld sculptures to massive pillars and buildings. Now this, let us see question number 29 based on this. Marble is nothing but calcium carbonate. its chemical formula is calcium carbonate CaCO3. So based on that, let us see a question. A student added 10 grams of calcium carbonate CaCO3 in a rigid container that is secured it tightly and started to heat it. After some time, an increase in pressure was observed. The pressure reading was then noted at intervals of 5 minutes and plotted against time in a graph as shown in below. See, here he observed the readings and he noted down what happens to each and every 5 minutes. During which time interval did maximum decomposition took place? So here time interval is not given. Actually here it should be given as 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. It should be given as it is. Now here let us see the options. So before going to options, I would like to tell you a small thing that for to make it decomposing of calcium carbonate, let us take okay best example like chalk piece. It takes a minimum 10 to 15 minutes time, but under these conditions, see here, see it is taken in a rigid container, moreover secured it tightly and started to heating it. That means here he increases the pressure. When there is increase in pressure, then it can be decomposed in very less time. So a decomposition took place in the options whatever less time is there. See here in the graph also less time 0 to 5 minutes. Within 0 to 5 minutes the decomposition will definitely take place. So here option D is the right answer. Now we see question number 30. Gas A obtained above is a reactant for a very important biochemical process which occurs in the presence of sunlight. Identify the name of the process. See, there is a biochemical process which occurs in the presence of sunlight. It is definitely photosynthesis. So here option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 31. Marble statues are corroded or stained when they are repeatedly come into contact with polluted rainwater. Identify the main reason. The main reason is nothing but if the water has acid, then in that case the marble statues will be corroded or stained. See, let us see the options here. Decomposition of calcium carbonate to calcium oxide. No, this is not the main reason. Polluted water is basic in nature. No, polluted water is acidic in nature. This is true, and hence it reacts with the calcium carbonate so that the statues are corroded. So calcium carbonate dissolves in water which give calcium hydroxide. Okay, that is not the reason for the situation. Here option C is the right answer. Now we see question number 32. Calcium oxide can be reduced to calcium by heating with sodium metal. Which compound would act as an oxidizing agent in above process? In this situation, when calcium oxide is reduced to calcium by heating with sodium metal, then calcium oxide itself will be acting as oxidizing agent. So here let us see the options. Option D is the right answer. Now we see Roman number 3, assertion and reason type questions. So we need to opt A when both A and R are true and R is the correct explanation of A. We should write B when both A and R are true and R is the not correct explanation of A. We should keep C if A is correct and R is incorrect. And we should write D if A is incorrect and R is correct. Now let us see question number 33. Assertion A is given as carbon dioxide turns lime water milky. So this is true. It turns lime water milky. This is true. The reason, carbon dioxide is an acidic gas. This is also true, but R is not the correct reason or correct explanation to A. Both are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A. So here option B is the right answer. Now let us see question number 34. Calcium, assertion is given as calcium carbonate when heated gives calcium oxide and water. This is false. This statement is false, incorrect. on heating calcium carbonate, decomposition reaction takes place. This is true. So here A is incorrect, whereas reason R is correct. So A is incorrect, R is correct. So here option D is the right answer for this question 34. Now let us see question number 35. Brown fumes are produced when lead nitrate is heated. This is true. Nitrogen gas is produced as a byproduct due to the decomposition of lead nitrate. See here, lead nitrate is taken. So it is decomposed. When it is heated, it gets decomposed and brown fumes will come. Brown fumes nothing but nitrogen dioxide gas. So here R is also true and R is the correct explanation of A. So here option A is the right answer. Now let us see question number 36. Assertion is given as, when white silver chloride turns grey in sunlight. This is true. When silver chloride, which was in the color white earlier, when it keeps under the sunlight, turns to grey. So this is true. Initial color is white, final color is grey. Okay, under the sunlight. This is true. Decomposition of silver chloride, means same, in the presence of sunlight, again same experiment, takes place to form silver metal and chlorine gas. The silver metal color is grey. Chlorine gas will be here given out. So it enters the atmosphere. So this is also true and this is the correct explanation of assertion. So here option A is the right answer. Now we see question number 37. Assertion is given as, pungent smelling gas is produced when sulfur burns in air. This is true. Reason is, sulfur dioxide is formed on the reaction of sulfur with oxygen. So here the sulfur dioxide only has the pungent smell. So this is true and R is the correct explanation of A. So option A is the right answer. Let us see question number 38. Assertion is given as, Fe2O3 plus 2Al gives rise to Al2O3 plus 2Fe. The above chemical equation is an example of displacement reaction. This is true. Why? Because when we compare iron with aluminium, aluminium is more reactive than iron. So aluminium will displace iron, or we can say iron is displaced by aluminium. So it becomes Al2O3 and Fe will be, it will be coming out. So here this is true. Aluminium being more reactive than iron, it displaces Fe from its oxide. So here this is also true and this is the correct explanation of this. That is the reason you see here, from Fe2O3, Fe is standing out by Al because it is more reactive. So R is the correct explanation of assertion A. So here option A is the right answer. Now let us see question number 39. The decomposition of calcium carbonate into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide is an example of thermal decomposition. This is true. Here, when we heat calcium carbonate, we get calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. See, in earlier question, we have seen that in question number 34, you see, calcium carbonate when heated gives calcium oxide and water. That is false. Why? Because here calcium oxide and water will not come. Here in place of water, carbon dioxide should come. That's why here earlier I said it is false. Now here you see the present question, you see, on heating we get calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Is not water, carbon dioxide. That's why it is true. Now when a decomposition reaction is carried out by heating, it is called thermal decomposition. So that is also true. When there is a reaction where heat is given for it, okay, where heat is supplied, that is called thermal decomposition. So this is also true. At the same time, this is the correct explanation of this. So here option A is the right answer for the question 39. Now let us see question number 40. CaCO3, that is what, again calcium carbonate, on heating gives CaO, means calcium oxide, and CO2, carbon dioxide. This is true. CaCO3 is insoluble in water. So here this is also true. But here if you observe carefully, both are true, both the statements are true, but R is the not correct explanation of A. So here option B is the suitable option. Next, let us see question number 41. Assertion is given as, potassium acts as a reducing agent when it reacts with H2O. In fact, potassium acts as a reducing agent is true. So here, when reacts with water, it acts a reducing agent. This statement is true. Potassium reacts vigorously with water. This is also true. But if it vigorously reacts with water, it doesn't mean that it can be reducing agent. So this individually both the statements are true. But this is not the correct explanation of A. So here option B is the right answer. Next, let us see question number 42. Assertion is given as hydrogen gas combines with nitrogen to form ammonia. This is true. Potassium metal, let us write true here. Okay. So potassium metal reacts with water to give potassium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. This is also true. But here this is not the suitable explanation for this. So here option B is the right answer. Now we see Roman number 4 statement type questions. Here three statements are given. If all the given statements are correct, we should put option A. If all the three statements are incorrect, we should write option B. If, for example, A and B are correct, first two statements are correct. If C is incorrect, we should write option C. If A and B are incorrect, first two are incorrect and C is correct, we should give option D. Let us enter the question number 43. Statement A says that dissolving quicklime in water produces white precipitate. It is not precipitate, it will dissolve in the water. So this is false. Rancidity of food is an example of reduction. This is not the example of reduction. This is the example of oxidation. So the given statement is wrong, false. N2 plus O2 gives us to 2NO, whereas here minus Q means you can send the Q this side. It is an endothermic reaction, so that here in this reaction chemical change is taking place. Actually this is correct. In this reaction chemical change is taking place. This is true. Here A and B are incorrect and C is correct. So option D is the right answer. Now let us see question number 44. Statement A says that a combination reaction may or may not be a redox. Means a combination can be sometimes reduction as well as oxidation, both can be taken place. Sometimes may be or may not be. So this is true. Statement B says a decomposition reaction may or may not be redox. This is also true, because decomposition reaction sometimes may be redox, sometimes may not be redox. Whereas statement C, the decomposition reactions are mostly endothermic in nature. That is true, because decomposition takes place when heat is supplied to it, when heat is given to the reaction. So all the three are correct. So option A is the right answer. Now let us see question number 45. Statement A says all displacement reactions are considered as redox reactions. So this is true. Almost all displacement reactions, considered as redox, because in those reactions reduction as well as oxidation simultaneously they happen. Statement B says that a double displacement reaction may or may not be redox reaction. This is also true. So in fact, combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, double displacement reaction, these are all may or may not be redox. Especially displacement reactions are absolutely redox. So in that case, all are true only. In general, statement C says, in general, a more reactive element displaces a less reactive element from its aqueous solution. This is also true. We have seen so many examples earlier. According to the reactivity series, the element which is more reactive, that can displace the element which is less reactive than that. So all the three are true. So here option A is the right answer. Now we see Roman number 5. More than one correct answer type questions. That means here not only single option, more than one, maybe 1, 2, 3, sometimes 4 also may come. Let us see question number 46. Among the following, which are the decomposition reactions? As I have told you earlier, decomposition means single compound can be broken up into more simpler substances. In short, we can remember that only one reactant and more products. See, one reactant, more products. See, all the four are decomposition reactions. So here, option A, B, C and D, all are the correct options for this question, 46th one. And here let us see question number 47. among the following which are the double displacement reactions? Double displacement, you know, they exchange, okay, their atoms. See here, BaCl2 Na3PO4. Ba came to PO4 and Na goes to Cl. So this is double displacement. H3PO2 plus NaOH gives us to NaH2PO2 plus H2O. So here, this one if you observe, this Na comes to PO2 and H will be going there, H2O. So this is also exchanging, so double displacement. AgNO3 plus NaCl becomes AgCl plus NaNO3. Ag goes to Cl and Na comes to NO3. So this is also double displacement. Now let us see last option. 2Ki plus Cl2 gives us to 2KCl plus I2. Here this K, it comes to Cl2, but nothing goes from this side to this side. So this is not the double displacement. This is only displacement. So here, however, option A, B and C are the right options. Option A, B and C are the right options for this question, 47th one. Now let us see 48. Among the following, which are more reactive than hydrogen in reactivity series? So let us have a look at reactivity series. More than reactive, okay, which one are there than hydrogen? You see, given options aluminium, copper, here Pb, lead and mercury. Let us see here all the four. See, aluminium, and then here what is given? Aluminium, then copper. See, aluminium, copper, lead, mercury. Once again you see, aluminium, here aluminium, copper, lead and mercury, which are there more than this hydrogen, means aluminium and lead, because copper and mercury, they are there after hydrogen. So which are here more? Aluminium and then here lead. So here option A and option C, these are the answers for this question 48. Now we see Roman number 6, matching type questions, in which question number 49, group A, some equations are given, group B, the name of the reactions are given. Let us here, we need to do match, okay, match the following. First one is 2AgNO3 plus Na2CrO4 gives rise to Ag2CrO4 plus 2NaNO3. That means here Ag comes to CrO4, Na2 goes to NO3. So this is a double displacement. So here option, first one, S is the suitable option. So here I am writing this is S. Let us see second one. One reactant, two products. This is decomposition. That is nothing but Q. So for second one, Q. Two reactants, single product. This is combination. So it is P. Here you see, from Fe2O3, Fe2O3 when reacts with CO, then from Fe2O3, Fe is displaced by carbon. According to reactivity series, carbon is more reactive than iron. So iron is displaced. So this is displacement reaction. So it is R. Now let us see the options. 1s, 2q, 3p, 4r. Let us see the options here. 1s, 2q, 3p, 4r. So option B is the right answer. Now we see question number 50. And of course, this is the last question of the worksheet. Here group A, there are certain equations are given in group B, and name of the those reactions are given. Let us do how to match them. Fe2O3 plus 2Al gives rise to 2Fe plus Al2O3. See here, from this Fe2O3, Fe is displaced by Al, since it is the more reactive than Fe. Al is the more reactive than Fe. So this is here displacement reaction. So first one R, chemical displacement. So here I am writing first one is R. Next let us see second one. Two reactants, a single product. It's a combination. So P. Here PbNO3 twice plus Ka gives us to PbI2 plus K2KNO3. See here is Pb comes to I, K goes to NO3. Double displacement. Here it is, chemical double displacement is S. This is S. And here single reactant, more products. This is what? Decomposition. So here Q. Q, chemical decomposition. And here C6H12O6, glucose plus O2 oxygen gives us to carbon dioxide and H2O. This is what here? Respiration. So here this is U. And here 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives us to C6H12O6 plus 6O2. Of course, this is the reverse process of respiration. This is nothing but photosynthesis. So here photosynthesis is T. So this is T. Let us check the options now. RPSQUT. RPSQUT. Okay. Luckily we got option A as the right answer for this question. If you feel this video is helpful to you, please like, share and subscribe our channel. And please do not forget to press the bell button so that you will get the notifications from our channel. Thank you very much.